bitch, that just came to play, baby. Yeah.
Baby, let me tell you, you so fine, you so sexy. Baby, let me tell you, you a dime. Baby, let's be friends. I can spend this money on a time if you let me.
What is up, everybody? It's your boy, King Boys Productions. I am back at it with another reaction video. Hey, that was kind of fire. I'm not going to lie. That was kind of clean. Y'all got to give me that one. That was kind of a little clean. I kind of hit. Okay, I'm sorry. Let me stop talking about it. But let me just say, I had to go to the bathroom before. I just recorded another video. The DaBaby video I just recorded before this one. And your boy had a little shit on my face. So how y'all not going to tell me I had shit on my face? No, I'm just playing. I actually hate when people do that, like in videos. Like especially vloggers do this a lot. Like, they'll be at the store. They'll have, like, two different options for something. And they'll be like, yo, y'all gotta tell me what I should get down below. It's like, yeah, bro, we'll tell you. We'll put it in the comments. And then they'll be like, I already bought it. It's next day when the shit comes out. Or it's the day of later on when you edit it. Vloggers do that so much. It's so, like I kind of, like... You know, the people that are pretty shady is, like, I know the Ace family, they're pretty, like, shady with, like, and, like, pretty, like, materialistic, that family is. But I do enjoy some of their content. They do that all the time. They'll be like, Ace family, which one should I pick? Comment down below. Who do you think will win? Comment down below. Like, that one's I can understand. Like, who do you think will win? But it's, like, or, like, they'll be like, y'all are not going to guess what we're going to do today. It's, like, you just clickbait. You told us in the title. You clickbaited it with the title. Or you told us with the title and the fucking thumbnail. it's like me going, hey, leave your comments down below. Left my fucking water up here. Leave your comments down below. What video do you think I'm reacting to today? Even though it's in the fucking title. Like, what video y'all think, huh? Huh? I'm sorry. I just had to go for that little rant because that shit, I don't know. When people do that, that shit kind of pisses me off. But today, we are here with One Hit Wonders and Hip Hop. 2010 to 2019. It's kind of tough with 2019 artists because it's like they just came out. So it's like it's hard to tell if someone's a one-hit wonder in 1 year. But I guess we'll check this out. I don't know how they determine like a one-hit wonder in 2019. Is it like, oh, their first song dropped earlier this year, their first big hit, and the rest of their shit isn't like popping? Because who knows? Like next year they could have another big hit. And then the year after that, they have another big, you know, so that kind of, I don't know. That one was a little confusing to me. But, yeah, we're going to check this out. I kind of would like to, from Hip Hop Universe, by the way. Also, I kind of want to do some more of these videos kind of sprinkled in. The only thing about these is these get fucking copyrighted, like, instantly. And you get, like, hit with, like, 20 fucking copyright strike or copyright claims. It's like every fucking song in the video gets copyright claimed, so... You know, your boy's not making any money on this video. So any brands, if you're a brand or some sort of sponsorship and you want to reach out to your boy, hey, that'd be great, you know. I'm not making money on a lot of these videos, so I would like to make some cheese. I would like it. So if you're a brand, you have a brand and you'd like to do some promotion through the channel, just hit me up in the DMs of Instagram or Twitter. Actually, if you're more of a business kind of shit, hit me up on my email, kingboysproductions@gmail.com. Or if you have any other... like reaction request, like paid promoted song requests and stuff like that. You can also hit my line on there too. But let's get right into this video. One Hit Wonders from 2010 to 2019. So let's get it.
This is the world that you know.
This said 2010, so I'm gonna guess they're not putting. Oh, sicker than the average. I'm guessing they're not. Okay, shut up, Matrix. So I'm guessing they're not. They're not putting those ones in there because it says 2010 to 2019. Because there's no way in fuck that Tupac and Biggie were one hit wonders. Can we just skip this little scene? Like, I don't know if I. Okay, here we go. Oh my god. It was like that. What you know about that? Yo, that song used to go hard as fuck at like dances and shit. In 2010, it was like for the couple of years after, it was like 2010, 11, and 12, a little bit of 13. That song would go hard as fuck at dances, and everyone would be dancing to it. You know, there's a lot of. I mean, my school was pretty like mixed well. So there was like There was like white people, black people, you know, there was Hispanic people. There was like a bunch of different races all in my school. It wasn't like there was, oh, all white kids are all black. You know, it was like a pretty well mixed school. And so like everyone was kind of killing it out there. I can't even lie. We didn't have like the stereotypical bad white dancers because like we kind of learned. We kind of learned from our classmates, you know, like how to actually hit that bitch. It was like, teach me how to Dougie, teach me. I kind of lost it because it's been a while, so y'all are going to probably flame me in the comments like, what the fuck? What the fuck was that? Can we stop with the Matrix? No. Yeah, but whatever happened to those dudes? Cali Swag District? Wasn't that their name? Cali something? What? No. No, there's no way in hell Waka Flocka was a one-hit wonder. Hard in the Paint? Are you kidding me? Round of Applause? You know, round of applause, baby, make that ass clap. That song was a banger. And so was Hard in the Paint. That song was a banger. And I know it wasn't his song, but this Wild Boy with MGK, yo, that was a banger. You cannot say my man Waka Flocka was a one-hit wonder. That's dumb. That is dumb. This song was a banger, though. All out of ass. Oh my gosh!
Rex on Rex.
Oh my gosh, dude. I always thought, like, for some reason, I always thought that this was YG, I think. I was always thinking, like, YG, because his name's YC. So I was like, I always thought, like, I was like, what happened? Why did YG change, like, his style and flow? So, like, for the longest time, I always thought this was YG. This guy's name is YC. Yeah, I don't know this song. Gucci Gucci by Krayshawn. I mean, she does not look like she can spit. This song sucks. Okay, did people actually fuck with this song? Or was this just, like, popular because it sucked? Because, like, if people actually fucked with this song, like... But, like, this song... This song sucks. Oh my gosh. Azealia Banks. Yo, Kirko Banks, he made a song with Fetty. I forgot what the song is called. That song was actually a banger, but yeah, this is the only song that Kirko really came out with that really kind of was hidden. Like, I got the drink in my cup. Yeah. Want a nigga like me, cause I ain't trying to control. We're not even gonna talk about us in there, Banks. I actually did not even know Azealia Banks made music. The only reason I knew about Azealia Banks was from that whole Wild and Out thing. If y'all don't remember that, like, she went on Wild and Out and they were like roasting her ass, cause that's what they do on the show. Like, the show, you go on the show to get your ass roasted. Like, that's the show. And they were, like, roasting her ass, and she was, like, getting, like, super upset or something. She was, like, crying and shit, and then she put out, like, this big statement saying, like, fuck Nick Cannon, fuck Wildin' Out, all that shit. It was, like, stupid as hell. It was so petty. It was just petty as shit. And then, like, they were all toasting her stupid ass. But then, like, yeah, I didn't even, like, I knew she made music, but... Trinidad, bro. Trinidad, I think he made the XXL freshman list this year too. He made the freshman list, but like, bro didn't do anything else. This song was kind of hot, but like, my man Trinidad, he was a character. Dog was a character. Oh, tattoos, fly whips, fly chicks, all that. Snapbacks. Oh my gosh. Yo, this song got super popular because of... Yo, I bet that there's going to be a lot of those songs that got super popular because of Vine on here. This was a song that I first heard on Vine, and then it started bumping. Like, people started playing it because of Vine. This is that one of those songs. Don't drop that, don't. Yeah, like, that part got super famous on Vine. There's probably a lot of songs from artists that are one-hit wonders that got popular because people were using them on their Vines and shit. Now, like, the same kind of thing is happening on TikTok. Full circle. Full circle, ladies and gentlemen. Fanatics. Don't drop that. What was that? Don't drop that. Ride with that needle. We smoking on Keisha. Yeah. Yo, actually, oh my god, this next song that's coming up too. That song Cash Out, what was his name? Cash Kid or something? Well, I forgot his name. Cash Out. His name was Cash Out and the song was Cashing Out. I think I heard one more song by Cash Out. It just wasn't, it wasn't that good. Cause it was like, when I heard this song, I was like, this is a banger. So I know that like his next song's gotta be a banger. It wasn't. And I don't know whatever happened to my mans. He's just gone. Like, I wonder if some of these artists still make music. It's just not hitting, you know? Or if they're just like, fuck it, I'm done. You know, like, I had the one hit. I'm out this bitch. Like, I wonder if that's, like, the case. Because, like, I saw, I can't remember what artist it was, but I saw an artist the other day was, like, still making music. Even though they were popular, like 10 years ago. They're still making music. It's just not hitting anymore. But like, I don't know if they still have like fans and shit, but oh my god, this song went so hard. So low, can't eat more. Sip done, period, look high, glow. No, no, we don't do more. I woke up in the I'm rich as a bitch. 100K, put that on my wrist. $200 put that on your bitch. You mean your model? That on my wrist. Okay. Yo, Ace Hood, he had a couple songs that I fucked with. Like, none that really were like bopping, like in like the media and shit. Like Bugatti was like that song, but he had a couple songs. He had one with Wayne, I forgot what it was called, but he had a couple other songs that were like actually banging, like off this album. And then there was like another album, like the next album he dropped, there was like two or three songs that I fucked with off that album. But yeah, besides that, this is probably the only one that really got media, that big of media attention. But it was like Vine again. Swallow a choke. What? So get like me. Why is this on here? Mike Will Made It? This dude's like one of the biggest producers in the game. What you mean? Is it because he didn't come out with like any other solo like songs like this? Yeah, that's stupid. I don't know who made this list. Mike Will? That dude's a big, like a huge producer in the game. I don't even think he was rapping on the track at all. Like this was like Juicy J, Miley Cyrus, and I think Wiz Khalifa was also on it. It was like them three. Them through rapping. He was just probably making the beat. It's like a DJ Khaled kind of thing. Like, it says DJ Khaled featuring all these artists, but it's actually DJ Khaled doesn't even make the song. Or he just makes, like, produces it and mixes, probably mixes it and shit. That's what Mike Will does. How are you going to say that he's a one-hit wonder? That makes no sense. You know it. So get like me. Oh. This song was a banger. Hand me back to the hotel. And go back to the hotel. Oh, what? No way, bro. No way. First of all, Bobby Shmurda been in jail for like the last... I think he went to jail in 2014, so he been in jail for 5 years. But y'all can't tell me, Bobby, bitch. Yeah, Bobby, bitch. You ain't know they call me. That song was a banger, too. You cannot tell me that this man's going to be... And it's, I don't think it's fair to put him in the one-hit wonder category because my man is in jail. Like, how are we supposed to know? Like, we can't know if he's a one-hit wonder. If he comes out, gets out of jail, and is dropping shit and no one's, like, fucking with it, then yeah, okay, I could understand. But first of all, this song was banging. But Bobby Bitch, that song was hot as fuck. Shot niggas, like you seen him twirl, then he drop, nigga. And we keep hey, free Bobby. Hey, yo, I heard a story about Bobby, and I don't know if this shit is true, but, like, I heard that, like, his boy, I think this was Bobby, his boy was about to get, like, 13 years or some shit like that, and Bobby was about to get out in, like, would have got out in, like, one or some shit like that, if he, like, would have snitched on his friend, but instead of not snitching, they both got six, or something, I saw something like that, like, him and his boy got busted for the same shit. And if Bobby would have snitched on his friend, he would have got 1 year and his buddy would have got like 13 or some shit like that. So he would have been out already. But he didn't snitch, so they both got the same number, like 6 years or some shit like that. Yo, that's a real dude right there. We be wildin', he's some hot nigga. Bitch, you guessed it. Woo! Yo, this is from Vine too.
You was right.
Yo, these songs got so popular because of Vine. And like I said, I think TikTok's kind of doing the same thing, kind of bringing it back, like with the songs that are getting popular because of a platform. But this song, bitch, you guessed. Yo, like, this came super popular online.
Bitch, you guessed it. Fuck nigga on sight.
OTT.
Got the club going.
Oh my god.
On a Tuesday. Got your girl in the car.
Man, this was a banger too.
I'm in love with the coco.
Yeah.
I'm in love with the coco. I got broads in Atlanta.
Yeah, I remember when I first heard this song, I really thought it was Future the first time I heard it. And I was like, oh, designer? This guy could be good. What happened? What happened to bro? I think he still drops music, I think.
I fuck with savages, you a fuck boy, you can't hang. You
can fuck not Slim Jesus.
My fucking gang. You ain't really bout shit, stay out my spot, don't speak my name, or I pull up and you're blocking night wearing all black.
Let the 30 bang. I'm 40 bang.
Now watch me, nay nay.
Okay.
Now watch me, whip, watch me, nay nay.
Okay, this, I feel like these artists shouldn't count because they make songs that are like dance style songs. Like, I guess the Teach Me How to Dougie was kind of the same thing. But I feel like those artists shouldn't really count. Like, if you made a song that was like a dance song that got popular because it's a dance song and people would like dance to it, I don't think that that should count as a one hit wonder. Just because it's like, yeah, technically you are a one hit wonder because you made that one hit. But, like, it's like, come on, bro. Like, you made a dance song. That's why it got popular. It wasn't even, like, a good rap song. Like, same with, like, Juju on the Beat. I don't know if Juju on the Beat's going to be on here. Like, Juju on that beat. But it was, like, it's a dance song. Like, those artists that made that shit, they haven't done shit since. It's because it was a dance song. So you shouldn't count, bro.
Okay.
This must have got blocked if you put it in. That's why it's instrumental, but... Uber everywhere. Oh, T-Wayne? I think a little bit with Made in Tokyo. He's had a couple other songs that I've kind of fucked with, but none of that really taken off, like Uber everywhere. Yeah.
Ain't too many things I ain't done yet.
I'm the king of this shit. Not boiling.
I'm just barely getting started. You already upset. I got bills.
Lunch Money Lewis? Who is this? But yeah, T-Wayne, I think he had another song too. He might have had a song with Fetty too, actually, now that I'm thinking about it. I think he had a song with Fetty too, but that song was banging, but this is the only song that really took off for my boy here.
Started, you already upset.
I don't know who this is. Do any of y'all remember this song? I don't remember this shit at all. I don't remember this song at all.
Hit the quad.
Yeah.
Hit the quad.
See, this is the same thing again. Was like a dance song. It got popular because it's a dance song. You're not a one hit wonder. It's like I said, technically you are, but like it's a dance song. So like people weren't fucking with you because of your talent. Like I'm gonna be honest. Like people weren't really fucking with you for the talent. They're fucking with you because. The way that you sing the song and the way that the beat goes, they can hit a dance. And, like, the way that they, like, it got popular, I think, on Vine, too. It was, like, stuff that you say in the song that, like, triggers, like, beats on HL, please watch your step, because I'm feeling myself. Throw that flag on the plate as my body got the rev. Da, 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 or some shit like that. I don't know the exact words, but it was something like that. It's, like, it's because it, like, matched up with, like, the dance that people were doing. Yep, here it is. Here's Juju on that beat. See, I knew this was going to be on here because it's like 22-7. This ain't 21, bitch. This 22. But like, it's the same thing. Like, it's popular because it's a dance song.
This 22.
Why did this man even come out, bro? Like, I'm going to be honest. Why did he come out? I'm 22 Savage. 21 Savage? No, I'm 22 Savage. He thought that was going to be a big hit, me and 22 Savage. You made one song that was kind of good, like, this ain't 21, bitch, this 22. Like, that song was kind of hype, I can't lie, but.
Young 22, love, grimmin' on a man.
Oh, what? Okay, this song. Broccoli. Yeah, that song was a banger, but he had that one song, Cash Machine. That song was popular, too. How was that a one-hit wonder? Like, Cash Machine? That song was popular as fuck too. I don't agree with this one. Yo, this beat drop was one of the best beat drops, like one of the best beat drops in, like, in my opinion, in one of the history, because I just love the way it's like Stone, and it's like Rob Stone, too damn fun. That beat drop is so fucking hard on this song, like to start it off. The song's good, but. Aw, I guess kinda. I feel bad saying it because, like, I fuck with Kyle, but he has that song with Kalani. Girl, why are you playing with me? Girl, who are you playing with? I don't know if that song really got popular. None of it. Like, I still fuck with a couple of his newer songs, but, like, none of them have really taken off like I Spy. Sucks.
She see money all around me. I look like I'm the man.
This song was so hot.
Yeah, but I was down and out like last week. Tell me, where have you been?
Oh, I hate to say it, but it is true. Like, Ugly God still makes some bangers, but, like, really, he just, his music hasn't been hitting like water. I fuck with your bitch with the water. I feel like I'm 21 Savage. I pull up, I'm fucking your daughter. Water, water. Like, it was such a simple song, but it was a good song. But he has a couple of songs that I still fuck with, but man. Fucking Lil Xan. This is the only Lil Xan song I actually like. You're done though. Yo, Ayo and Teo, another dancing song. But like, I feel like that, I get that one too. But Big Shaq kind of came up as like a joke. Like, the whole thing was like, I think the guy's name is Michael Dappa, I think was the guy's actual name. But like, he made a Big Shaq, and the song itself was like a joke song, but it took off. I don't know if he still releases music. Y'all have to let me know down below if my man still, like, actually releases music as Big Shaq or as Michael Dappa. Y'all have to let me know. And if it's actually good shit too.
Rolly, rolly, rolly with a dapper ranch. I already got some designer
tattoos on my pants.
I just want some ice on my wrist so I look better when I dance. Have you
Yo, like, low-key, I actually do fuck with some of their other music that they've dropped. I actually fuck with some of it, so. But it hasn't hit.
Maddox
in the building. Yeah. Yo, Maddox, I don't know what, I've never heard any of his other music. Like, I heard this song, obviously. But he had that one song with X on his album. It was just like dollars, like $3 signs, I think. It was like ooh, ooh. He was kind of hitting them little notes. I was trying to beat a case, but I ain't beat that case, bitch. I did the race. Skirt, skirt. Yo, it's the same thing with TK, bro. It's like, he's in jail. Like, how do you know that he's going to be a one-hit wonder? First of all, I don't know if he's ever going to get out of jail, which, like, I mean, he killed somebody. Like, I don't know if he should get out of jail, but, like, if he does, we'll have to see if he gets out of jail, if he, like, actually makes another banger. Like, we don't know.
Eli Blast, cricket foes,
like a face.
I got hoes
calling. I hate to admit it. I hate to admit this one just because, like, I kind of fuck with Shaq West. Or Shaq West. I said Shaq West. Shaq West. I kind of fuck with him, but, like, yeah, bruh. Are you going to drop something else, bruh? Like, he dropped that album, and I haven't heard from him since. Like, are you going to drop something, bruh?
Oh, where's Ollie?
With the motherfucking bumps.
Come through.
You and you.
I'ma get the money. Drizzy, get the loot. Pull up with that
Draco. Yo, but Block Boy also had the shoot. He also had that song. So I don't know if that was that song not popular? Just the dance became popular. I feel like the shoot became, that's like a popular song because of that, or because of a, because of the dance, it became a popular song. And then he had this one as well. But I could be wrong. I blow you like a fool.
Leave me alone.
I like it. I like Flip De Niro's voice, so I hope he comes out with more shit.
I'm a cow, bitch. I hate this song. I literally hate this song. I don't say now, bitch. I'm a cow, bitch. I'm a cow, bitch. This song sucks. I don't know this song.
I don't know it. No! How? How is Lil Tecca a one-hit wonder? He just came out! Ransom just came out. He just dropped his album and it was doing pretty well. When was this video made? I got something to say. Yo, how? That makes no sense. Lil Tecca should not be on this list. He just came out. You don't know if another song is going to go popular. Like, that's my problem with the 2019 list. It's like, how would you know? Just because he hasn't had like a big hit like Ransom yet? Another big hit like it? You just know automatically that he's going to be a one-hit wonder? No!
Fanny Prada when I am alone. I needed me a diorata, I need me to want.
When I popped off, then your girl gave me just a little bit of
I feel like these guys are, like, I feel like they're going to be popular, because this song is, la, 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 la. Yeah, this song is pretty fire. I hope Boy West Coast, I hope he's a one-hit wonder. Like, this song sucks. You was at the club. Like, the little shitty auto-tune that they put on his voice, too. Dog is not talented. They just put that stupid-ass auto-tune on it, and I don't know why this song is popular. It sucks. This song sucks. And, like, people are making it so popular. You was at the club. I can make this song. Like, I just have to sing shitty. You was at the club. Something, something. I first met you. And I just put hella auto-tune on all that shit. And it's a bang. Come on. He sounds literally like a robot. You gotta be. How? 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 How is this? How is he a one-hit wonder? That makes no sense. Shot of Flow has like 100 million like views on YouTube. Like Shot of Flow 3 has just went gold, I think. Camelot, that song's doing numbers right now too. How? Like how? How? That makes no sense. And he just came out. How is he? I don't agree with this bullshit. That is bullshit. Cowboy boots. See, this song, I feel like this song became popular because of TikTok. So this is one of those TikTok songs, but yeah, the song goes hard, bro. It goes hard.
I will give you the world, baby girl. You just gotta be worthy.
If his XXL cipher was any determination on how this guy will do, he will be a one-hit wonder. But like, this song was hot, so I think if he comes out with another like song kind of similar to this, I think he can go. I don't think he'll be a one-hit wonder. And he just had that song with DaBaby and Chance and Gucci. That song was banging. So like, I hope this.
You don't gotta be perfect.
I like his voice. I like his voice.
I hate to be responsible for destroying your career. A one-hit wonder.
Okay. Yeah, shout out Hip Hop Universe. I don't agree with a lot of their choices. Because, like, I don't agree. Like, I don't agree with some of them. Because they just made no sense. Like, the dance songs, I don't feel like but should be on there. Even though I guess technically they are one-hit wonders. Also, the fucking, like, Waka Flocka? How? How is Waka Flocka on there? And then, like, just those two at the end really pissed me off. NLE and Lil Tecca? How? They just came out, bruh. Like, how can you say that they're one-hit wonders already? That makes no sense. Just because, and I don't know if that's because it's their opinion that they think that they're going to fall off after this. But it's like, how, bruh? Like, look at the numbers they're still doing on all their songs. Like I said, I hope Boy West Coast, I hope he's a one-hit wonder because you was at the club. When I first met you. Yeah, that song sucks. But if you guys did like, please leave a like, please subscribe. Original video is in the description down below if you'd like to check that out for yourself. Look, it's a long video, you know, and if y'all stayed to the end, I appreciate y'all. You know, show your boys some love on the channel. Just, you know, put a couple likes on it, some comments. It helps get promoted to other people. I realize it's like a 30-minute vid, so like some people aren't going to want to watch it just frankly on that. But, you know, if you could just support your boy, you know, maybe post it on like your Instagram, you know, shit like that. Share it around on Twitter and stuff like that. Get your boy some exposure. I'd really appreciate it. So, thank you guys. And until next time, it's your boy, King Boys Productions. Squaw! Realize your dark side collides inside you.